Pardon me, sir. I hate to disturb you. You look so cozy and settled and nice, but would you happen to have $20 so a person could get a cup of tea? Inflation, you know.
Or how about you, madam? What a lovely coat. The prettiest I've ever seen. Can I have it?
Generous friend in the back of this place.
Hey!
We'll have supper tonight.
Yeah!
Some for doing her chores, and endless they were, is the star of our play, a poor little orphan girl whose name you all know. Now, you know her name, don't you? So go ahead and tell us.
Cinderella.
Cinderella, that's perfect, you're right, for this is the story of...
Cinderella!
An echo, how odd. Well, I've heard this story dozens of times, but I'll stick around and tell it, for I never get tired of the magical, tragical, comical tale of lovely...
Cinderella!
Cinderella, Cinderella, why haven't you finished your chores, you lazy thing?
Cinderella, close the door. My food's getting cold.
Cinderella, open the window. I need some fresh air to blow up my volleyball.
Cinderella, fetch me my chair. I'm tired of standing.
Cinderella, rub my neck. I'm such a kink.
Cinderella, your chores!
Cinderella, my chair!
Cinderella, the door, my neck!
The door!
The window!
Poke the fire, make some tea, sweep the floor!
Really?
Yes, really.
I mean really!
And now, how close your mother must speak to you.
Not you, although to my own daughters, thank you.
But I am.
You are her stepdaughter, and now that your father is gone,
you must find your place.
Yes, mother.
Ravishing, she makes me so.
smile. Ooh, don't they look lovely?
Who asked you?
May I help you to the carriage, Mother dear?
You certainly may not. She probably doesn't want you to stick your head out the door lest someone see the soot on your nose.
A scandal, an outrage, that's what you are. Now go scrub your face.
I'll make a nice pumpkin pie for you.
To celebrate our victory, we'll buy me next time. One of my girls will have
a... I think they'll find the prince.
Yes, they will capture the heart of a handsome prince. Don't just stand there, make that pie.
I'm coming, girls, here comes Mama.
Pumpkin pie? Well, pie does sound delicious, and perhaps she'll save a small piece of crust for her new friend Patches. There was really nothing to complain about. Even though she wouldn't get to ride in the royal carriage. Even though she wouldn't get escorted up the steps of the palace, through the courtyard, and into the grand ballroom. Even though she wouldn't get to see the lords and ladies in their finery. Even though the prince wouldn't ask her to dance. Cinderella, there you go, dreaming again. When there's work to be done, shame on you, Cinderella. Now off you go to the pumpkin patch and buy pumpkins for your delicious pumpkin pie!
Laugh at the thought of it all.
Perhaps she's right. These braids will never make it through.
sing. You woke me, my friend. I'm tired. I'm exhausted from banging all day. This better be good, Patches, old chum.
It's very important, for I have made a new friend, you see. It's young Cinderella, and she has a dream.
Well, dreams and wishes are my specialty, that's true. So, Patches, just what can I do for you?
Nice rhyme.
Thank you.
Now, quickly, go to the house at the top of the hill, go through the back door, and down to the cellar. There you'll find Cinderella, Porky, no doubt. She'll tell you her story and explain what she wants. Now, off you go, Annie, for help where you must. Annie!
in their finest evening clothes. How she wished she could see the king in his great ruby crown. And of course, the prince.
She would watch as he asked lady after lady to dance, and then finally, he would come to her. He would bow deeply. He would smile and say, "My lady, I would be honored if you waltzed with me."
Oh, yes, Your Highness.
Then, she would take the hand of the prince and they would waltz on in the night. And her stepmother and stepsisters would gaze with envy. But this is the cellar and not the great hall. And surely a broom is not a prince. So she got back to work, but not for long.
My turn, Patches.
Now's the time, Annie. Rags, go catch up with the other beggars before they make a wrong turn.
You'll stick around and join the fun, right?
Happy to help.
Oh! Oh! Why, Cinderella? Don't look so startled.
I must be dreaming. Who are you?
Who am I? Who am I? Why, I am. That is, I was sent by. You see, I am.
Oh, I know. You must be my fairy godmother. I've read about all the fairy godmothers and all the fairy tales.
Yes, yes, that's right. I am your fairy godmother. Now, what's a fairy godmother?
What's a fairy godmother?
No fairy. I asked you first.
Well, she's a magical friend who arrives just in time to fill all your dreams.
And dreams are important, for how else would you know what to wish for?
Why, that's a very handsome broom, and it dances very well.
Cinderella, what do you think all the other ladies who aren't at the ball are doing tonight? Why, they're wishing and dreaming they were there.
What about you? Why aren't you at the ball?
Well, someone had to keep the house tidy.
If I were you, I would just leave. I'd leave this place.
They make you work really hard when you could go someplace else and be paid very well.
Oh, I couldn't leave my stepmother. She married my father, you see. And I promised my father before he died that I would stay and take care of her. Oh, I wish she were here. There I go, wishing and dreaming again.
Well, everything starts with a wish. And what are you wishing for right now?
Oh, it's silly.
Come, dear, tell us.
Well, you see that great big pumpkin in the corner over there, the biggest one of
all? I stumbled over it in the dark.
She nearly squashed us!
Oh, that's nice! That huge dog! And the creepy cat!
now we must be ready.
Except for one thing, a bit of advice. Now, wishes and fairy tales, as I recall, last only one day. And this day is nearly over. And by the strike of midnight, all of your wishes will just fade away.
She's lovely! She's gorgeous! But now I must go. Goodbye for now, Patches!
It's nap time, you know.
Till next time, then, Annie, and thanks for your help.
Come along now. Well, there it is. The prince's house.
Ooh!
Just in time, for here is the first coach full of swells. Now,
here they come. to help, son. She's forgotten her shoe.
Thank you, dear mother. Now let's go inside. For tomorrow, I shall bind my wrap.
Whatever you say, sonny boy.
And after the ball, the visitors all returned to their home to revel in the memories of the glorious event. Oh, there were so many people. So many swells.
Just thousands there.
Oh, yes, indeed.
Thousands at least.
And the ballroom was beautiful, decorated just so with music for dancing.
Dance for hours.
At least hours.
Did you know anyone there?
Nearly everyone. Nearly.
Except for one girl who arrived very late. Who she was is a mystery to all.
Did she dance with the prince?
I think I saw her dance with him once.
And do you think he liked her?
Oh, my, no!
She was there only shortly. And what about you, Cinderella? Did you work very late?
Till just after midnight.
You slept soundly, I hope.
Spent the night dreaming.
Dreaming of what?
Of the ball, of course.
Oh, nothing could have been as wonderful as being there. It was perfect, delightful.
And not only that, having yourself with the princess has to choose the bride, he'll choose one of your sisters who are very fine.
How he'll choose between them, I really don't know.
My love, you or you will be the bride.
Oh, you must try the slippery